Good afternoon, Amitabh. This is Vandana. Let's hear from you about the resolution 2020-583 by Alderwoman Maria Hadden of 49th Ward of Chicago.
Good evening. I am pretty disturbed since last July when this absurd and nefarious resolution was brought into the city of Chicago. We've been fighting it since last July. We have deferred it six times. This is the seventh time. It is coming up for a vote now in the city council on March 24th. On the first ground that it talks about the Citizenship Amendment Act, we have to think about it. It's an amendment. It's not the official act. Citizenship Act of India was formulated back in 1950 based on the British India division into three parts, based on religion. That was decided by, approved by UN, decided by then Viceroy of India, the first Premier of India, the first Premier of Pakistan, the Constitutional Assembly of India, the Constitutional Assembly of Pakistan. They all agreed on this framework for Citizenship Amendment, Citizenship Act, which states that only Muslims, faith, people belonging to Muslim faith will go to Bangladesh, Pakistan, and people who are of other faiths can come to secular India, where they will be automatically granted citizenship based on their migration to India due to the partition of India. But the law was limited in its scope. It lasted till 1955, December 31st. People who arrived in India after 1955, December 31st, been lingering for past 70 years to get an opportunity to become citizen. Three, four generations who are born in India, raised in India, do not have a right to be called Indian citizen because they are children of the refugees who came after January 1st of 1956. The Citizenship Amendment Act is a generous humanitarian act which allows these people who are already in India a pathway to citizenship, a fast pathway to citizenship. It's equivalent to Lutenberg Amendment in the United States. It's equal to what we are looking for, the undocumented citizens' path to citizenship in the United States. In what part is this is oppressing any religion or any caste or any creed that the resolution claims to be? The resolution said the Muslims are excluded. Well, you look at the original law, that exclusion was made by and agreed by the countries involved. It is not something new that this CAA has proposed. It is just a checkbox allowing people to pathway to citizenship, dignity in life, respect in life. And if anybody has an objection to it, it is heartbreaking to see that. It is brought by, it just came to know, it's been brought by the Council of Islamic Relations in America. They are purporting it that it is their resolution. We'd like to remind the Chicago Council that the Council on Islamic Relations in America is a designated terrorist organization by the United States, United Arab Emirates. Its Dallas president has been convicted by the US courts in 2009. It is funded heavily by
Hamas.
It's funded heavily by people from Middle East who support Hamas and other terrorist organizations. The CAIR is under investigation by the State Department for a very long time and is continuously being monitored. So the city of Chicago does want to get involved with a resolution brought in by CAIR. They have to really, really think what this will do to the Indian American community, who's always been helpful, who's always been quiet, who's always been working for the growth and betterment of the society in the United States. Thank you.